Good morning, everyone. Anthony Esteves here. I just wanted to wish you all a happy Sunday, a post 4th of July Sunday. Hope you all celebrated well. Hope you had fun and you were safe. I thought I'd give you a little insight into the four guests that I have on this first episode of season 2 of Based on a True Journey, my podcast. So you may notice that this time around, I went a little different. Whereas the first season, it was me narrating moments in history to you, like the Stonewall riots, Stonewall uprising, the acts of Arash Deeds, the Sousa Mensch, who saved 30,000 refugees during World War II, or the Holocaust. Actually, it wasn't quite World War II yet. With that season, I narrated a story to you. And with this new episode of season 2, which is called Aftermath of Crow, Four Journeys Through Racism, I wanted to take a different approach because I wanted there to be a needed weight to this episode. I didn't want to take other people's experiences and tell them myself because I felt it would remove the emotion and the personal effect that these stories have on these individuals. So I asked four close friends of mine to tell us their journeys. Four black friends of mine, and you know, explaining what they had gone through in their lives regarding racism and discrimination. Specifically, one key moment that had the biggest impact on their lives. So to give you an insight on these four individuals, I thought I'd give you a brief little background on who they are. So first off, we have Paris. Paris is one hell of a creative talent. He is musically inclined. He's got the voice of an angel. And if you want to check out his songs, you follow him as Judah Black, B-L-A-K. Judah Black, he's available on Apple Music. He's available on Spotify. Pretty sure he's available on Amazon. You can follow him on social media. His Instagram is simply Judah Black, remember, B-L-A-K. You can follow his social there and you'll have access to all of his music. Give him a listen. The guy has a velvety voice and some bangers that you need to put in your playlist. I'm just saying, the guy's musically talented. Also, someone who's very creatively talented in a different aspect is Bree. And Bree is a makeup genius. You follow her and she has this beautiful way of just creating elegant makeup, and she is an arts and crafts master. So follow her Instagram page, Bree_creative. Look at what she can make for you. Ask her if she can make something for you and she'll let you know what she can do. But the woman is genius with her hands. Okay, Bree_creative. Check her out. The third guest was Havan Baraka. Havan, I met online through our love for Batman and Michael Myers. And we connected after that. And we're both writer actors. He has a little more cred to him right now because he's actually making more original projects, whereas yours truly is mainly an extra. I was an extra in The Pursuit of Happiness and an extra on 13 Reasons Why. He's actually got indie starring roles he's doing. So Havan Baraka, one of those key stories he wrote and starred in is called Castles in the Air. Castles in the Air. Check out that series. The guy is a comedy drama master at what he's doing. The guy doesn't consider himself an actor. He considers himself a writer. But I'm telling you, the boy can act. Okay? So go find Havan Baraka. He goes by Black Bruce Wayne on social media. All right? Black Bruce Wayne on Instagram. And Havan Baraka everywhere else. Check the guy out. The guy is a talent. The guy is outstanding. And last but not least, a woman who has been a part of my life since the early 2000s. TV criticism professor, Dr. Michelle Foss Snowden. She was the fourth guest on this episode. And you can catch her work on a podcast as well. She is the TV doctor. That's right, the TV doctor. She breaks down television shows, episodes, deep into the process of what is happening in that show. Not just what's funny, not just what's dramatic, but what the key elements, what story are they telling, what are they touching on in our society. What are they not touching on in our society? What are they lacking in? She breaks every TV show down to its foundation, and I swear when you listen to her show, you will have a newfound respect for television shows and the way they are made and how they can change your viewpoint of entertainment, of media, how TV shows can actually have an impact on society. She's the one you need for that. Now, if you want to follow her on Instagram, she goes by TVPHD. That's TEEVEEPHD. Okay? That's the TV doctor, Dr. Michelle Foss-Noden. Those are my four amazing guests that were on this first episode of season two of Based on a True Journey. Probably one of the heaviest, it is the heaviest episode that I have done on Based on a True Journey. Okay, so please, if you haven't yet, go check it out. It's on Apple Podcasts, it's on Spotify, it's on Google, it's on Overcast, or you can go to the Based on a True Journey website, which is truejourneypod.com. That's truejourneypod.com for every single episode of Based on a True Journey, or your favorite podcast app. All right, so there you have it. Those are the guests I had for my first episode of season two. There are more episodes to come, going for 10, as always. We'll let you know when the next episode will be out, but until then, enjoy this one because it means a lot. It is it's a heartfelt, heartbreaking episode about four journeys who had to deal with the hate of racism and discrimination in their lives and how those moments changed them, okay? So check out Aftermath of Crow, Four Journeys Through Racism, the first episode of the second season of Based on a True Journey. All right? Otherwise, have a great rest of your weekend. Take care. And remember, journeys are what define us. Where will your next journey take you? Until next time, stay on the path.